In this video, we're talking about dimensional analysis and powers. That is, when you're converting between two different units that are raised to a power, and you don't have a direct conversion between them, but rather you have a conversion between the units without the powers. So, for example, you want to convert between centimeters cubed and inches cubed. Well, you know from the table of conversion factors that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters. So you see you have a conversion between inches and centimeters, but not between inches cubed and centimeters cubed. This is how you do it. So all you do is you first write down the conversion that you know without the power. So you write down 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters, for example. And then all you do is you raise both sides of that conversion, that equality, to whatever the power is that you're dealing with. So in that case, you'd cube both sides. So let's look at an example here. So think about that. So we want to convert 729 milliliters to cubic feet. So the question is, how many cubic feet cubed are there in 729 milliliters? Well, this is dimensional analysis, so we set it up the same way. Step one would be to write down a blank, and then the units of our answer, which are going to be feet cubed. And then step two, our starting point, which would be 729 milliliters. And now we're going to write down conversion factors. Well, whenever you have a conversion that involves volumes, milliliters is a unit of volume, and cubic feet, anything cubed, any length cubed, excuse me, is a unit of volume also. Anytime you have something like this where one side is cubed and the other side isn't, almost always you're going to use this conversion factor here that I asked you to memorize. 1 milliliter is exactly equal to 1 centimeter cubed. Because you see what that does is that gets us from milliliters to centimeters cubed. Once we go there, now we can do what I was just talking about. We can write down that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters, which isn't exactly what we need, but it'll get us there. And then we cube both sides. And be careful, you guys, when you're cubing this, you have to cube both the number and the power. Now, because 1 cubed is just 1, it stays like that, and the inches become cubed. But 2.54 cubed is 16.387064. And by the way, I wrote down all of these digits here because this 1 inch equals 2.54 centimeters is an exact conversion, and so it's exactly this. That keeps it exact. But at this point now, we have a conversion between centimeters cubed and inches cubed. So you see we went from milliliters, which is our starting point, to centimeters cubed. Now from centimeters cubed, we can go to inches cubed. And then again, we don't know, probably off the top of our heads, the conversion between inches cubed and feet cubed. But you do know that 1 foot is equal to 12 inches, right? Sure. So all you do is you write that down, just like I said up here. Then you raise both sides, in this case to the third power. When you cube 12, you get 1728. The 12 is exact, so this is exact here. And it's inches cubed and 1 foot cubed over here. Now we can finally go from inches cubed to feet cubed, and we'll get our answer. So make sure that makes sense. This is a really useful tool. So let's finish it out. So we have 6 milliliters to start with. So we take 1 centimeter cubed is equal to 1 milliliter. Put the milliliters in the denominator so that it cancels, just like that. And then we need centimeters cubed to cancel, so we use that conversion between inches cubed and centimeters cubed. Centimeters cubed cancels. And then we cancel out the inches cubed by putting the 728 on the bottom. And we're left with units of cubic feet, which is what we want. So let's look at one more example here. We want to convert 0.114 pounds per inches cubed to grams per milliliter. Now, this has you doing two things. First, it has us doing what we just did, doing a conversion with a power. But it also involves these compound units, which you've seen a couple times. So whenever I have a compound unit, you know, something over something, pounds over inches cubed, grams over milliliters, and I want to convert from one compound unit to another, so we want to go from pounds per inches cubed to grams per milliliter. The way I always do this is I take the one we want to arrive at, our answer, and we set it up like this. The top is always on the left-hand side of the equal sign. That's the number that we want to get, and our starting point is always an exact one, and the units on the bottom. So we want to calculate how many grams is equal to 1 milliliter for this problem. And the next part of this is always that the compound unit that you're given the number for, that's always a conversion factor. So in this case, we'll say that 0.114 pound is equal to 1 inch cubed. And that converts between pounds and inches cubed. But we can't use that quite yet because we're starting at milliliters. We have to get to inches cubed before we can use this conversion. So we do the same thing we just did. We say, okay, 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cubed, exactly. And then we say, okay, well, I know that's good, but I want to get to inches cubed. Well, I know that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters, but that's not cubed, so that's fine. I just cube both sides, right? Cube this, cube that, and I end up with 1 inch cubed is equal to 16.387064 centimeters cubed. And we also know, because we want, and what all this will do for us, okay, so let's, we can now go from our starting point, milliliters, to centimeters cubed, and then here we can go centimeters cubed to inches cubed, and then this lets us go from inches cubed to pounds, and then finally we know that 1 pound is equal to 453.6 grams, and we'll arrive at the units that we want, grams. So let's look at it. So we start out with how many grams is equal to 1 milliliter. That means we need milliliters in the bottom, so we come back up here, put that in the bottom, milliliters cancels. And then we have centimeters cubed, so we need centimeters cubed in the denominator. Put it there, and it cancels. Then we need inches cubed. We come up here, use the inches cubed. Make sure you know where all these guys are coming from. And then we have pounds. We need to cancel pounds, so we look up here, we see that. Cross it off. And we're left with grams, which is what we want, right? Grams. So we put these in our calculators. And by the way, you guys, when you're watching these videos, you should have your calculators there and put the numbers in and make sure you get the same numbers I do. Anyway, so I get 3.15, 3 sig figs because of the 0.114. Everything before that's exact. The 453.6 has 4 sig figs, so the least is 3. And so my first insignificant figure is a 5. I put it as a subscript, then I round up, and I get 3.16 grams. So what did we just figure out? We figured out that for this substance, whatever substance has a density of 0.114 pounds per inches cubed, that density in grams per milliliter is 3.16 grams per milliliter.